instead of their own values, such as, and as a result of their feeling out of control, they continue to be during this subconscious state until the sound of the raging water awakens them at some point and that they discover that they're 5 feet from Niagara Falls in an exceedingly boat without oars. At this time they are saying, oh shoot, but it's too late because they're going to fall. Sometimes it's an emotional downfall, sometimes it's a physical downfall, sometimes it's a financial downfall. To avoid a catastrophic fall, we must awaken a robust force within us to resist the flow of life, then shape our destinies in line with our values. This power is sort of a giant who was hibernating in an exceedingly cave deep inside us. During this video, I will be able to show you ways to awaken your giant and break the chains that prevent your giant. First, to awaken your inner giant, you wish an inspirational vision of what you would like. Robin says the secrets to make a vision inspirational is to place yourself during a state of mind of absolute faith within the full expectation that you just can create anything you wish. Imagine being a toddler again on holiday. You're in a very outlet getting ready to sit on the lap of patron saint. If you talk over with the youngsters before Christmas, you will not they need absolutely no problem bobbing up with a fun infamous list. They tell you, I'll tell you what I need, I would like to swim really. I would like two swimming pools, one for you and also the other on behalf of me. Now there are four areas of life where you would like to define exactly what you would like: personal and professional development, adventure, game goals and contribution goals. For now, let's specialize in his business career and your life. Determine what you actually want in your business career by asking yourself, what I'm visiting be if I do know I cannot fail. Pause minutes to put in writing your answer, suspension of self-judgment, and writing anything that involves your mind. Write quickly and write freely so you're feeling strong inside. You come to life inspiring and excited for the long run. Once you arouse your inner giant with a compelling vision for the long run, you want to remove any limiting beliefs that will be holding you back from pursuing those dream. Limiting beliefs that resemble chains linked together with your giant's leg. You may assume that it's unbreakable because you assume it's reality, but Robbins reminds us that almost all of our beliefs are generalizations about our past, supported our interpretations of traumatic experiences you will have didn't pursue a project within the past, and accordingly, you think that you're incompetent if you think that even it's true. It becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy, and therefore the next time you think that of an exciting business project, you think that carefully about why until I try I won't follow it anyway. For now, take a pair of minutes to put in writing down three limited beliefs, a couple of career and business. Search for generalizations like in any respect, or never or always. Fail to cast doubt now on these limiting beliefs by questioning the source of every belief and therefore the accuracy of every belief. Sort of a lawyer who files a case against every belief, or a skeptic that refutes the conspiracy theory. If you've got a belief that you simply don't seem to be a creator because someone in your past has severely criticized our creative project that you just have undertaken, and so question the source by asking yourself about the wonderful work they need done. Are they experts during this field? Maybe they were just trying to bring you to their level of doubt. After questioning source of each belief within the accuracy of every belief by thinking of counterexamples, consider a project you thought you'd never complete but somehow found the way of thinking during a time you had a job offer after you thought nobody wanted to rent you. After questioning each of your limited beliefs, replace each of those beliefs with a powerful belief. Within the book that Robin says, if you had a belief that I could never succeed because I'm a girl, it'd be your new belief because I'm my woman, resources available to me that no man can dream about. Then ask yourself, what are some references that I should support this idea in order that I can begin to feel confident about it, such as you reinforce and strengthen this belief. He will start directing your behavior in a very completely new and more powerful way now that I weaken your limiting beliefs and make more enabling beliefs that you just trusted those chains that were preventing you from pursuing a dream. But now you need to change your neural connections to pain and pleasure so you'll separate from these chains once and for all. If you didn't move consistently toward a giant dream within the past, it had been because you didn't. We do not associate enough pleasure with work and enough pain with inaction like our beliefs. We forget that we will modify our pain-pleasure associations. Robin says the key to success is learning the way to use pain and pleasure instead from feeling pain and pleasure. you'll be able to begin to manage pain-pleasure associations by associating pain while doing it. Imagine yourself procrastinating and so put yourself at the peak of the pain state by repeatedly asking yourself what this may cost me within the end and what this may cost me within the end. When answer what it'll cost me within the end, imagine sitting on the couch or hitting the snooze button or hold up on the net a day over the subsequent year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. So look and feel the miserable life your slowdown has created, feel the pain that regret the suffering related to inaction, then ask yourself, what's going to this cost within the end? Imagine all the people continuing the struggle because you didn't intensify and share your knowledge of a grip or build this product that you just can build for the one you like and which you may disappoint if you retain taking no action, just stacking enough paint within the work related to the tremendous pleasure of working. Here are two reliable methods I found useful. The primary, to associate an existing variety of pleasure with the action you would like to put in writing, has always been a painful experience on behalf of me, but since I wanted to become a constructor, erased one line, I had to alter my pain association to writing to try to do so. I only allowed myself to pay attention to my favorite music. Okay, I used to be writing my mind. I linked the pleasure of being attentive to my favorite music to writing, and over time, that pleasure went beyond the pain association with writing. Now I anticipate to writing and that I don't even have to hear music. While the second, thanks to associate intense pleasure with work, is to associate intense feelings of pride and private growth with taking action toward your goal. The most successful bodybuilders consistently show up within the gym because they flood their bodies with feelings of pride and private growth after each iteration. By doing so, they reconnected a painful experience within their minds to be fun in the end. Awaken your inner giant by setting inspiring goals in work and a private development adventure for business and contribution. When setting your goals, ask yourself, what I'd do if I could not fail? Then break the chains that are preventing you from following. Form these goals by identifying a minimum of 3 restrictive beliefs related to each goal, then challenging these beliefs by questioning their source and accuracy, so replacing all those along with your leaders bound by new empowering beliefs, and at last reprogramming the pain-pleasure associations that link immense pleasure, action and intense pain on the duty. Robin says that understanding and using the powers of pain and pleasure will allow you once and for all to make the changes and enhancements you would like for yourself and people who care about it. The hat you gathered from Awakening the Large Inside Tony Robbins. This book proves why Robbins may be a pioneer within the field of self-help. I like to recommend it. If you liked this video, please share it. Thanks for watching.